sounds like pretty good.
I didn't bring my magazine in a little autograph.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Hey, Nydia. How are you doing this morning?
Good morning. I'm doing great, Kurt.
Hey, Travis. How are you? Cindy, how are you?
I'm good, Christopher. How are you this morning?
How are
you? Are you ready?
I'm going to stay quiet. I'm going to listen up. Oh. Can I actually do this? Can I stay quiet?
Yeah, this is the
podcast. I'm going to see.
I should have had, you know, I've been losing.
Hello, Cindy.
Hi,
I'm good.
How are you, Nydia?
Good morning, Commissioner Amos. I'm well. Thank you.
All right. Well, then, I don't know if we can take this much wisdom in one corner.
I said,
I don't know if we take this much wisdom in one corner.
I offered you.
Yeah. We might should separate y'all.
Good morning. How are you doing today?
How are you? Welcome back.
Good morning, Dennis.
How's it going?
Doing wonderful. My first time to film you on the
I'm getting so old. Go back and compare that to some of your old film.
I'm sure there's some changes with me as well.
Good to have you this morning.
Thank you so much.
Here.
Good morning. Hey, Kurt.
Hey, man.
How are you?
Good.
Good morning.
Can you exercise your rocker in my house?
Good morning, Dave.
Hey, Anna, good morning. Morning, Kristen. How are you? Nobody is looking
down. I told him that I was a city. I like both of you.
I don't know what you're talking about, but I agree.
I don't wish him harm by any means, but
is
Dale Bay. Just
rush. We're making progress.
Welcome you all to the joint meeting between the Forsyth County Board Commissioners and the City Council and Mayor of Cumming. I'm going to read this notice real quickly here. It's a notice to of the public, notice to the public of a special call joint meeting on June 5th, 9 a.m. of the Forsyth County Board Commissioners and the City Council of the City of Cumming. Notice is hereby provided to the public that today a special meeting is being held between those two boards. It will occur here in our building. I'll just go through that actually. I'd like to call the meeting to order at this point. This is our special call joint meeting as is statutorily required by the state when we enter into joint SPLOST negotiations. Does anyone have any changes to the agenda? City of Cumming, do you have any changes to the agenda?
No.
And staff, council,
and? Vice Chairman Semanson, if I may, just as a not really point of order, but in consultation with the city attorney, it does not appear that the City of Cumming has a quorum, which is perfectly fine. That's okay. Not a problem at all. Just want to recognize that. That would explain why they're not opening their meeting formally, because at this point they don't have a quorum.
Okay.
But that does not in any way denigrate from the usefulness or the necessity of this meeting, but I just want to make that clear for the record. That's why also I suspect, and I can't speak for them, but I suspect it will not be adopted an agenda either, is because they don't have a quorum. But again, that doesn't take away at all from the utility of this meeting.
So we actually will have second opening then of their meeting, and
I don't think that they'll have a quorum here today, and again, that's perfectly fine, but okay. For purposes of today, the county government can go ahead and adopt the agenda.
Okay.
The mayor and obviously members of the council are here to listen and participate fully, but only we will be following the protocols of an actual open meeting.
Okay, thank you for the clarification. Do you guys anticipate that you will have quorum?
No.
You do not? Okay, and then we will proceed.
I have a motion to adopt the agenda.
Thank you.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. All in favor? We have four in favor with Chairman Levent absent. So here we go. County Manager, would you like to open the discussion of where we are at this point, how we got there?
Certainly. Commissioners, Mayor, members of the City Council. So we're in a meeting today that's statutorily required. The current SPLOST 7 period ends at the end of June next year, and so the county's been working over the last few months towards looking at SPLOST 8. And looking at the history of SPLOST, historically, most of the SPLOST periods have been 5 years or less, but as you're probably more aware than I am, The current SPLOST was a six-year SPLOST, and so we have put together a proposal for a six-year allocation of funds, assuming that we'll do a six-year SPLOST, but that's not required. As we've looked at revenue estimates for the six-year period that would begin next July 1st, our current estimate, using a fairly round number, is $274 million. So we've been working through a process of considering roughly $274 million over a six-year period. Now, the Board of Commissioners, 3.5 years ago, in anticipation of a $200 million general obligation transportation bond referendum, made a commitment for the board. It's a non-binding commitment, but it's one that we've been factoring in as we've talked about the SPLOST that's coming up. They made a commitment to pay back $100 million of debt issued as a result of that $200 million in bonds. As of today, we have not issued the second $100 million. So part of our discussion has been that we might shift $100 million worth of projects that the county had into the next SPLOST program and actually pay for those projects with SPLOST revenue, as opposed to issue bonds, have some issuance costs, and then turn around and pay off those bonds. In terms of how we've looked at the allocation of money, which is really the purpose of starting the discussion today, what we've done is to look at the $274 million, and statutorily, these two governments can agree to any amount of distribution. The default formula is to look at the most recent census population, with the county getting a percentage that's equal to, in this case, the 2010 unincorporated population as a percent of the total population, and the city then getting its proportion, again, based on the 2010 census. And using that, the city's share based on the population in 2010 would be 3.1%. Now, the county is adding population each year that's in excess of the city population, so that percentage will go down, and it has in fact gone down since 2010, but I think the SPLOST language in statutes specifically encourages that we would use as a starting point that 2010 percentage. And based on $274 million, that 3.1% would be $8,494,000. What I've encouraged the board to consider during discussions is that, and as I've had some informal discussions with the mayor, to the extent that the city has projects that benefit a broader population than the city, that we consider that additional funding come through the county's allocation, and that the board consider projects that the city may propose that we see as beneficial beyond the city's boundaries, and I think you can probably name several past projects that you see as having a broader benefit, and the board consider adding those. And what that addresses is one of the issues that came up in the recent Sharon Springs discussion, which was the proportion of revenues being shared with the city, and the proposed city of Sharon Springs looking to use that as justification for them wanting to have their own opportunity to negotiate with the county for revenue sharing. But I think from my perspective, it's a way that the city can look at projects that may exceed that population-based share, but at the same time, the county have the opportunity to say that we're taking on city projects because they have a broader benefit than the city population. We've gone through a process last week. The board basically allocated its share, which is $165.5 million, to specific projects and programs. And I have detail on that if the board is interested in looking at where you ended up at the end of your discussion. With that, I'll stop the introductory remarks. I think the purpose of today is to try to seek some common ground in terms of how the allocation can be made. And we need to have a decision made this month on an intergovernmental agreement if we're going to reach an agreement, because in early July, the voter registration board needs to basically set the stage for a November referendum, and we need to stay on the schedule to accomplish that.
Thank you for the introduction. So basically, we used some input that through a series of town, not town halls, but open house type meetings throughout the county. as well as some online surveying that was used to draw in citizen input to help us to drive to what types of projects would be most desired by the community. And the buckets, of course, were broken down into transportation being the highest priority category, then followed by parks and rec, and then, of course, public safety took on another proportion of that through both the sheriff and fire departments. Additional categories that we had separated out were senior services, some expansion of water within the community to areas that are not presently served, some money set aside for our county facilities, and then, of course, for the animal shelter and recycling solid waste or line items in and of themselves. There's a lot of detail behind some of the transportation projects, but the basic categories broken down came to a total of $49,369,937. So that's kind of a very specific number, but it rounded out to 18% of the total SPLOST expenditures. That includes both intersection improvements, widenings, those types of projects, and then also a small portion set aside for economic development. So it will help us to encourage better commercial development here in the county. Parks and Rec was driven into three types of projects. Basically, the Greenway standing alone as its own project, the renovation of existing parks, and then the development of new parks. The Parks and Rec total came to $40 million, or 14.6%. The Sheriff's Office, we have set aside for development of West Precinct, also for equipment and vehicles with that section totaling $10 million. And then going down into the Fire Department, $13,500,000, and that would include a training center and lots of apparatus, alerting systems. The smaller categories are going to be not really small. And water and sewer is also another $10 million for new water lines that will help us to reach areas that are not presently served, people who are still on wells. Facilities, $9 million. $5 million to senior services facilities. We're looking at improving our delivery of senior services by co-locating with our Parks and Recs department with reaching a broader audience with our Parks and Recs facilities. Solid waste, $250,000. We do have grant money also that feeds that will augment our services in recycling and solid waste. $9.1 million for libraries with the addition of a Fowler Road library in South Forsyth. Animal shelter is looking to expand their dog runs and create a mobile adoption and vet vehicle for a total of $830,000. So that's kind of the overview. I guess at this point, does the city come forward with any types of projects that they're looking to accomplish, or just any initial feedback on the discussion or the comments made by the county manager?
Well, we've got a list of projects that we can share with you. We're wanting to do a northern bypass connecting Highway 9 to Pilgrim Mill Road, which would allow traffic to go from 400 to Pilgrim Mill all the way to Highway 20. Extend that up driveway.
Do you have a copy, take your copies of that? I do. Can you pass me something?
Thank you.
Would the intention of that be that it become a truck route? Pilgrim Mill?
Excuse me?
Would that anticipate Pilgrim Mill, would that become a truck route?
It could very well be. We've had discussions with the state, and they really love the idea that it would bypass a lot of traffic through the square where we tend to bottleneck. Which 306 on the drive is a state route. What we're looking at is extending from Highway 9 at Sony Drive and going over and tying in with Pilgrim Mill. So that gives people the ability to come from 400, go over, hit Highway 9 north or south, go to Highway 20, go west. That would greatly alleviate
make some downtown square traffic.
Do you have a cost estimate on that?
We do, but we're looking at, do you three lanes, four lanes, so that could obviously change it.
And also, don't you have development coming in that will help alleviate some of the costs?
Yes, part of this road will be paid for by a developer.
Great incentive.
But irregardless if that development doesn't happen, you know, the city would be, I think it's a very worthwhile project, traffic-wise. So, if we don't have the help, then we would still.
And with them widening 20, that's huge too.
Yes. The next thing we have is extended Meadow Drive, building a new road at Veterans Memorial at Castleberry. Here again, to alleviate pressure on the square. Have problems with people turning left at the square near Goodson's, and traffic backs up, and people are in the wrong turn lane on Veterans Memorial trying to bypass it, so we laid that out a lot. Building a new road from Highway 20 to Sawney Drive, basically where Pine Lake Drive is. And in that area, some parking decks, an amphitheater, and a new Veterans Memorial, War Memorial. In that road would probably require a bridge. Then we're looking at aquatic center expansion, extending the arena at the fairgrounds to be able to house another 1,500 to 2,000 people. And then we're looking at a Dobbs Creek Rec Center expansion and also air conditioning. So that's our list.
Do you have dollar amounts?
I don't have all of them. We've got pretty good numbers, but I don't have them with me.
On that first one, Troy, do you have, or I guess maybe Brumbalow, sorry.
Always fine.
Do you have, have you met with GDOT, and are they saying they want it to be a four lane?
No, I've met with them and had discussions, and they said once we had engineering done that they would try to find some money to help pay for that as well, but there's no guarantee to that. And they didn't say one way or the other, three or four lane. That's kind of until Highway 20 gets expanded. Have 8 lanes of traffic on that road, but if you can't get on Highway 20, you know, it doesn't really do you any good. But at least creates that vehicle to go east and west on the north side of town. Because until they expand Sony Drive, that's only 2 or 3 lanes. We would at a minimum put a 3 lane road in depending on what the city has on cover. Dover Mill would be a straight shot from 9 to 400. It would create a turn to come into town. That way traffic is continually flowing east-west.
Any idea what would come into Pickle Mill Road yet?
Where's
going to come intersect Dover Mill Road?
Just south of the church. Right there. We would be coming in through Northdale subdivision. The city owns property in there, so we would have to buy a little bit of property, a house or two, to be able to make it happen. But it would be this intrusive way of getting there.
And you, of course, talk to the developer that's looking to develop, and they'll incorporate that in their plan.
Yes, they're. Potential development plan show this route going.
And are they showing it as a four lane or?
We can do a four, we can do a divided three, or center turn lane. Kind of the issue we have, if we go to a four lane, then we still have part of the city road up to the mill that's a center turn lane. So to really do it, we need to bump the number up to widen the rest of the building now to make it continuous.
sections. I mean, you need to do it. You could phase it.
No.
Shift over to the Veterans War Memorial. Is your idea or your plan for that to bring it to its present location, or would you to relocate it?
No, we would be looking at and doing a completely brand new War Memorial.
At that site or a different site?
A different site.
Different site. Do you have the property for that already, or?
Not at the moment.
Quick question on that. Is that in conjunction with the ABBA or the other groups, the mayor, or is that?
Yes, I've talked with pretty much all of those, and what we're able to do is incorporate it into a park so that it actually, I think, gets used a lot more, gets seen, interacted with, instead of it being over where it's only kind of used for 2 days out of the year, that it can be incorporated in.
Yeah, those old veterans like to go to those things.
Right.
So, is that you, Amos?
That's our.
If Mayor, I mean, without some cost to these, you said you have them, what are y'all looking at for SPLOST dollars? 3%, 4%?
You know, we were going to be happy with one, if it gives us three, then.
One, as Eric said?
Yeah.
So we could work on the 3.1, please?
We had a lot of these projects are directly beneficial to the county as a whole. I'm not looking for things that have projects for us. We're looking at what can we do to make it better for the entire community, not the incumbent for South County.
I think Dobbs Creek is a major one for me. I love for South County parents to be complaining about air conditioning with our non-county parents, city parents, just for South County citizens using. That's one big complaint they need to air conditioning.
Our parking ramp facilities and the aquatic center and all that, they are used primarily by county residents. We couldn't fill a 10-year-old baseball team with city residents. You know, we couldn't fill a basketball team with the same age group of kids with city residents. But yet we're busting at the seams. But those are benefiting the entire community.
Well, can you, to me, can you get us some cost and we'll see how far the 3.1 goes?
Yeah.
Some of these will benefit the county. Cassidy, Meadow Drive, Cassidy. It's not all citizens of Cumming use that.
Right.
I work on that road, and it's packed up today.
This will bring up, leave in a lot of traffic, people trying to get around the square.
So, make sure you need to know some cost. Eric?
Yeah, I think if we're going to move forward, you know, key is we need to secure intergovernmental agreement this month, so the sooner we can have some details, the board has the opportunity to work with the city to finalize the joint list.
If I may, Mayor, are you saying 3.1 total or 3.1 percentage? I just heard say.
Yeah.
3.1 percentage total, including all these projects, will be included in the amount?
I was making a joke with Pete.
Well, I said good.
3.1, I said we'd be happy just to get 1%.
I understand that, but yes, sir. So.
And you asked Eric's first thing was that the farmer comes out about 3.1, does it, Eric, based on 2000?
Yeah, that's the population, as I said earlier. I think to the extent that you want to relook at the list of projects you came up with last week in order to incorporate any city projects that go beyond that 8.5 million that under a population split that goes directly to the city in order to incorporate some additional projects, you certainly have the opportunity to revisit your list and incorporate projects that you think are a priority for the county.
And I think that's what you're trying to say, is that number, are you looking at projects or are you looking at that number?
Thank you, that's what I'm trying to get. Is it 3.1% total or the 3.1% for population split plus some joint projects, which would be this list you have?
We didn't look at this list based on any percentage. We looked at it as what we felt were important projects for the community.
And this is the total that you mean? These projects right here? This is what your total is asking for SPLOST, this list?
No, this is just a list of potential projects.
It doesn't have a price. So to me, Dobbs Creek would be
So I understand all that. I'm just trying to clarify. So this is your project list. Would you like to get completed within the SPLOST 8, correct?
Yes.
Okay, excellent. But not in addition to a 3.1%?
No.
Okay.
Total.
Total, thank you.
Yes.
And when can we have some real numbers, do you think? Because we're coming down to the deadline for a vote.
And by the end of the day today or tomorrow, too late.
Excellent, thank you.
Would we need to then meet back, all of us together, or no?
Not to discuss and circulate those numbers, no. When you're going to absolutely have to meet back again is if you ratify the government agreement and resolution calling for this possible, but not just to have the county have to review those numbers for certain. Well,
can we add that to the next work session?
And just to clarify, there would not have to be another combined meeting. But once we have an agreement between the city and the county, then the city would approve the IGA, the county would approve the IGA.
So our next meeting is Tuesday. Should we go ahead and just put something on the work session agenda now?
Sure.
So you have it at least advertised in case we do want to take action?
Keep the inertia going, yes.
Yeah, well, before we make a motion for that, though, I also want it discussed at the work session, something that the county manager mentioned at the beginning about that non-binding. I know that the county attorney got out to all of us the language that was in the resolution about the $100 million.
You're talking about the resolution regarding the $100 million of geo debt versus flocking.
And there's been some discussion about, well, are we going to, how we're going to repay that? Are we going to take the first $100 million? Or are we going to do it? And I think we need to have discussion about that, because to me, that was binding. I know you said, I know we can't bind a future board and all that, but we voted, me, Pete, and Todd were on the board.
That's correct. And I agree to a certain extent, although by now, our intention on that was we would already have borrowed the full $200 million. And we were going to pay back $100 million out of SPLOST. But since we haven't borrowed a second $100 million, the whole question was why even borrow it just to pay it right back again?
But it needs to be, I mean,
we're just talking about putting this on the agenda, then to discuss, put that in a work session, let's do it. I hate to take up the city's time. Is that purely county
exactly.
issue?
Exactly, but I think we need to publicly discuss that so people don't construe it a different way on Facebook or make up their own. It needs to be discussed.
Probably have a few meetings, but that sounds like this further discussion is a good idea.
Eric, as soon as I get the numbers to you, can you circulate them out to us?
Most certainly.
And okay. is this a prioritized list or just a list at this point?
Just a list.
Just a list.
And when's our final vote on this, Councilor? When do we have to have this?
It's not determined yet, but I think that the critical plan the county manager was looking at was sometime in early July. Trying to get at a minimum the IGA put to bed. That may not be absolutely required in the law, but that's the critical path we put together.
If we can do it earlier, we'll do it earlier. If not, July 5th would be, I think, your last meeting before the voter registration board will meet the following Tuesday, and they would have to at that point set the item for referendum.
All right, so I guess we'll make a motion that we put this on the next work session agenda for further discussion, and hopefully it's an IGA in play by then.
Second.
And is that the only motion that probably necessary today? Because we're not finalizing anything today, correct?
Absolutely.
Motion is second to make sure this carries forward to the next work session. And that passes 5-0.
Mr. Chairman, may I make a respectful suggestion before we adjourn? And that is, send that over to the city, and the mayor has gone over project list, just an offer for them to provide you additional information they may want to provide you, just so we have not foreclosed that before we adjourn this meeting. Very rare we get together, and so I might just offer that you ask that one question before we adjourn.
If you'd like to ask them what kind of snacks or coffee or drinks, they might come back and visit more.
We were offered.
All right, so Julius, let's say, I mean, you understand what the counselor said, you guys are good?
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Okay. Is there a motion to adjourn?
Second.
Second. Second. And we're adjourned at 9:32 a.m.
Or Tuesday. Thank you.